wouldn't make it. They said that I'd never get to the top.
I remember that.
There was nothing they could say that would make it stand.
How I created a relationship with Khaled. It's funny, man, it's a funny story. I was actually just in my house one day. Honestly, like I was just really just chilling. I was home, sitting down, relaxing, watching TV. You know, my manager back at that time, you know, he knocked on my door, was just like, yo, you know, Khaled got this little contest he do. I seen him, I was like, yo, what's up, man? You know, I heard about you got your contest or whatnot. You know, I want to spit for you. I want to give you the reasons why I feel like, you know, I should perform at your birthday bash. And he called back and was like, yo, I want to hear him on a bigger record. You know, so he sent the I'm So Hood instrumental over. Sent that over, I ripped that down like a movie. You know, I was nervous. I recorded that verse like 25 times. Ended up finishing it. As soon as I finished it, I sent it to him. He was like, yo, I love it. I'll never forget, it was the office right across the street from the radio. I met with him. And we pulled up, you know, we waited for him. As soon as he left the radio, he came over. And he, you know, he proposed that. He was like, yo, you know, I would love to sign Ace Hood to We The Best Music. You know, and from that day on, man, all I can remember is getting in the whip and just crying, you know what I mean? I couldn't stop the tears from flowing, you know what I mean? And the first person that I called was my mom. It just is indescribable. You know, definitely what it represented. It just, I felt like the worries, you know, the struggle, you know what I mean, the hard times, those are things that were, you know, were able to be exited out of my life. You know what I mean? Those are the first thoughts that came to my head. You know, the times in which, you know, my mother cried and, you know, in which I watched her and she, you know, she went through, you know, watching her go through surgery and not being able to pay the bills and things of that nature. Those are the things that, you know what I mean, really, it opened me, you know what I'm saying? It opened me. That shit made me tear up. Thank you, about that shit. You know, I remember them days, man, you know. You know, you know, in which she couldn't pay the bills, you know what I mean? And she needed help. So, you know, nobody could help her. And that was the day I never forget. I walked in my room and I prayed, you know, and I didn't have a job or anything, but I literally prayed. I prayed about it, you know what I'm saying? And a few months later, like my whole life changed. You know what I'm saying? And now she's able to smile now, you know what I'm saying? You know, what was once a dream, you know, is now my reality. You know what I mean? So I'm living it, man. I'm in it.